Welcome to a presentation on logarithms. The goals of this video are to graph a logarithmic function, convert between logarithmic and exponential equations, and also to solve exponential equations using logarithms. Now, this video does assume that you have been exposed to logarithms before, and it does just serve as a quick review. A logarithm is defined as follows. Y is the power which we raise a to get x. A is called the logarithmic base. And we read this as the log base a of x is equal to y. Now it's important that we realize the three major components of a logarithmic equation. This little number down here is called the base. So when we write this in exponential form, a will be the base. A logarithm is an exponent. So what the log is equal to end up being our exponent. And the value of x here in the log will be the number, or what it's equal to in exponential form. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Let's convert this logarithmic equation to an exponential equation. And we have to basically answer these three questions. What's the base? The base is 2. Since a logarithm is an exponent, 3 is our exponent. And the number part of the log is equal to 8. 2 to the third equals 8, and that's correct. So we're going to ask those same three questions over and over again. Taking a look at this log equation, the base is 3. A log is an exponent, so our exponent's negative 2, and it's equal to the number part, which is 1/9. Let's try it in the reverse order. We know we're going to have a log, so let's write that down. It's going to be equal to something. So same three questions, what's the base? The base is 6, comes here. The exponent is 2, therefore the log must equal 2. And the number is equal to 36. Log base 6 of 36 is equal to 2 because 6 to the second is equal to 36. Let's try one more. We need a logarithm. Now on this one, there's no exponent given, so we know this is e to the first power. So our base is e. The exponent is equal to 1, so the logarithm is equal to 1. And our number is 2.718. Now this would be approximately because we do have an approximation over here. Now one thing we have to recall is that we have log base e, that's called natural log, and we don't use this notation. We use ln for natural log. So natural log 2.718. is approximately equal to 1 because e to the first power is approximately equal to 2.718. Okay, now let's take a look at the graph of a logarithmic function. The first thing we have to do to graph this is write it in exponential form. So I'll rewrite this in terms of y. We'd have y equals log base 2 of x, which means that 2 is our base, y would be our exponent, and it would equal x. Now when you're graphing a logarithmic function by hand, notice that y is the exponent, so it's going to be more convenient for us to choose values of y and find the corresponding values of x. So essentially what we're going to do is we're going to raise 2 to the power of y, these powers, and find the value of x. So 2 to the first power would equal 2. 2 to the second power would give us an x value of 4. 2 to the third would be 8. 2 to the 4th would be 16. 2 to the power of 0 would give us an x value of number 1. Remember, 2 to the power of negative 1 is the same as 1 over 2 to the power of positive 1, which of course is equal to 1/2. Okay, let's plot these points. 2, 1, 4, 2. The rest of these will be off the screen, but we can plot the point 1, 0 and the point 1/2, negative 1. And our graph would look something like this. We can see that this logarithmic function is increasing over its domain. Its domain would be the values of x greater than 0. And at this point, I think it's going to be helpful for us to compare the graph of this logarithmic function with base 2 to the exponential function of base 2. So here we have, in blue, our log function. And in black, we have our exponential function. And I've also graphed the line y equals x. And what this shows is they're symmetrical across the line y equals x, and that's because they're inverses of one another. So there's a lot going on here, but the main idea is that they're inverses of one another. Notice how this has a y-intercept of positive 1, the blue graph has an x-intercept of positive 1, and they're symmetrical across the line y equals x. So log functions and exponential functions are inverses of one another. Now here's a list of a bunch of properties for logarithms. I'm not going to go through every single one of these. You may want to pause the video and just refresh your memory. The major ones here, we have the product property, the quotient property, and the power property of logs. And the last one here would be our change of base formula. Let's go ahead and apply these in order to solve exponential equations. In general, the best way to solve an exponential equation is isolate the exponential part and then take the log of both sides, apply the power property, and solve for the variable. Let's see how this works. If we want to solve this for t, we want to remove t from the position of the exponent. One way to do that would be to take the natural log of both sides. Now the reason I'm using the natural log is because the natural log is one of the bases that's on the graphing calculator. We could also use common log if we wanted to. Now the reason we take the log of both sides is now we can apply the power property. I can take this value of t and move it to the front. So we would have t times natural log e is equal to natural log 40. Now, natural log e is actually equal to 1 because the base and the number are the same. But just in case we didn't remember that, we could still divide by natural log e, basically isolate the t. This would simplify. And so I would have t is equal to natural log 40 divided by natural log e. But of course, again, this is equal to 1. If we evaluate the natural log of 40, we'll get approximately 3.6889. And it's pretty common to go to 4 decimal places. Of course, we could easily check this. What we're saying is, if we take e and raise it to the power of 3.6889, we should get approximately 40, and we do. It makes a little bit off, of course, because this is rounded. Now, the second method to solve this would be to rewrite this as a log equation, meaning we'll ask those same three questions again. Our base is e, our exponent is t, and our number is 40. Now remember, log base e is natural log 40 equal to t. It's a little bit faster. This method is a little bit faster in this case, but sometimes it may not be. I personally like to stick to the standard procedure of taking the log of both sides and solving for the variable. Let's take a look at another. First step, we need to isolate the exponential part. So we need to get rid of this minus 4 and also this 2 here. So step 1 will be to add 4 to both sides. So this would be equal to 9. Now we need to divide by 2. This would be equal to 4.5. And again, what I'm going to do is be consistent and just take the natural log of both sides. Apply that power property. I take this exponent and move it to the position of the coefficient. But we know natural log e is equal to 1. So now we just need to divide by negative 0.05. So the value of t would be approximately negative 30.0815. Let's take a look at number 3. Again, the first step is going to be to isolate the exponential part. That's this part here. So we're going to add 19 to both sides. 341 plus 19 would be 360. And we're going to divide by 2. Let's go ahead and take the natural log of both sides. Again, I could take the common log, but I'm in the habit of taking the natural log. Apply the power property. So we'd have x plus 1 times natural log 3 is equal to natural log 180. Now to solve for x, I'd probably divide by natural log 3, get the decimal approximation of this, which for the sake of time is 4.7268, subtract 1 from both sides, and we'd have 3.7268. Again, if we want, we can go back up here and check it, but I already have, and that is the correct value of x. Okay, I hope this quick overview of logs was helpful. Thank you for watching.